Hi guys, I know it's been a long time since I've been on the channel. Yep, I know that. I understand that it's been a month, maybe? I'm not too sure, but things have happened in my life and I just couldn't. I couldn't even edit the video that I've had for like 3 weeks. So that'll be after this video, so you'll see that. It's just a shopping trip, but it's quite fun. Anyway, today I'm going to watch QPR versus Ipswich at Loftus Road. So let's go back to London. We are waiting for a train. We have like 20 minutes to wait. No, we don't. Say hi. She's got her shirt on. Mine's here because we've got to get number seven on the back because at the minute it only says free, but still, yay. But yeah, I'm just listening to a bit of My Seconds of Summer and yeah, so we're just waiting. I've got a vanilla milkshake and Abby needs a drink. Freshly printed number 7. Yay! How excited are you now you've got that? Is it nice and warm still? But mine's done. I can't even hold my camera like this, but mine's done. Here's my arm. I just need to go and change into it. And I got my shirt on. Hang on. Oh yes, number 7. And Abby's behind me. And he's on the program. Actually really excited about this. Let's go find our seats. Yeah, what are you doing? You're doing a catwalk over there.
No, I was just doing my legs. See it in
that. Oh.
Thank you.
You've got an incredible array of QPR legends standing with you, Andy. And as we celebrate the 100th anniversary since our first game here, what was your personal standout moment on this pitch?
Of course, really hard to say one. What I would say, in my 20-odd year career, I had the best memories of my career here at Loftus Road, in front of you, our fans. You know, if you're pushing me on an individual one, scoring on my home debut at the Loft End, you know, scoring my one and only hat-trick came in here at Loftus Road. But it's a team game, and I played with some amazing footballers, some of them behind me today. You know, very proud of playing 92-93 when we were top London club. You know, we used to beat Man United, Man City, Tottenham, Arsenal and Chelsea. We beat them here. And what makes this stadium so unique, so special? The fans, you know, it's very close to the pitch. You know, the atmosphere on certain times could be electric. And I'm sure when the team are playing well and they're with you, these fans, they can intimidate the opposition. It's a special place to play.
Okay, just a word on the forever arts. QPR's known for its history, its heritage, and re-engaging with these legends of our club stood with you. It's been so important, and so appreciated by the fans.
Yeah, I'm really proud. You know, there's a lot of people that helped to make it happen. But to see the guys over the last sort of couple of years coming back, the fans love it. There's a real desire within the club to get back to our history. These guys are our history.
And how much has it meant to you personally to be a driving force behind it?
Yeah, very much. You know, I'm one privileged to play here, but to get back in touch with some of these guys, to engage with some people that I read about or people told me about, to play alongside, then to see their careers once I had gone, has been amazing.
And what impact do you think the Forever Arts has had on these guys that are back on this Loftus Road pitch today? I mean, let's not forget, some of them hadn't been back for 10, 20 plus years before the Forever Arts was formed.
Well, it makes them feel good, it makes them feel very proud, you know, that what they did here at Loftus Road for this great club will always be remembered, will never be forgotten. And what I would say, I'm speaking for myself, but I speak on behalf of these guys behind me, every single one of them, that he's just scored a goal, every single one of these great men were privileged.